cloud here at Spacefear in Dunedin on the 24th of April 2018. I'm just going to talk about a few more of my paintings, or two more of my paintings, going back to the 1980s and early 90s, that have some relevance to me as a gay man and might be of interest to other gay men out there. This one is Moment by Moment, which was produced in a period of relationship difficulty for me. I was sort of involved with a younger fellow, 7 years younger than me. I was in my late 20s at the time, and we both had kind of different relationship goals. I, back then and still now, am looking for a kind of committed monogamous relationship, and he, like everyone I've been involved with since, just wanted friends with benefits. So yeah, bit of trauma there, and I got pretty depressed for a time. And my first drug experience, which is with ecstasy, my only drug experience is with ecstasy, and that kind of lifted me out of a pretty low state and inspired this particular piece of artwork. This is about establishing priorities in life, coming to terms with the reality of the universe, your place in the universe, and trying to become a bit less attached to things. You can't take non-attachment too far, because you have to be willing to get close to other human beings if you want to have any quality of relationship, be it a friendship or something more substantial. And you have to be able to get attached to elements of the world around you, otherwise you're not going to really live or be engaged with life. So yeah, here an idealized version of myself is the only solid element of this painting. Everything else around me is just fleeting, just passing through my field of vision and disappearing back into the underlying universe. That includes my partner here at the time. He's just sort of starting to disappear. I'll be moving on to a state of solitude, perhaps future relationships, and ultimately all of us merge back into the fabric of the universe and the infinity of time. So yeah, comment to gay men in general, I think that we're a bit inclined to be rather overly optimistic in our relationship ambitions, and or alternatively you can get obsessed with the chase, the pursuit of some particular ideal man, which tends to happen through sauna facilities and on Grindr. And the end result of that is, if you're obsessed with relationships, you're probably going to get seriously frustrated and maybe seriously emotionally hurt, and you're just going to waste a hell of a lot of your lifetime on something that really is unattainable. If you pursue these lesser kind of goals of one night stands and fleeting encounters, you're going to end up sick, more than likely. You're going to hurt other people, and you're probably going to end up dead well before your time, as well as, once again, waste a lot of time that could be spent on better priorities. I say that for us, if you're not making babies, your priority needs to be to do something with your life that makes the world a better place, will contribute to the improvement of civilization. A career of some sort. You know, within yourself what your talents are, you know, focus on that, focus on something, as I said, that's going to make the world a better place for future generations. For me, I have to focus on artwork, and I've also got this interest in Arboretum projects. I've done three of them, working on the third one in Twizel. Hopefully something good will come of that, but certainly the artwork. As I get older, hopefully I'll be able to focus a bit more attention on subject matter that's important to me, and ideas that I think are worth communicating to the world, ideas that I hope will inspire other people to do what I just said, to make the world, civilization, a better place. This other work over here is The Man in His Dreams. An aspect of my nature that has been a bit of a struggle for me to manage has been this kind of obsession almost with physical beauty. It's been something that's, you know, it's been lacking in myself. I just haven't got the genetic makeup to have ever been physically beautiful. And of course I'm having to contend with the reality of aging as well now. But even if you are lucky enough to have this physical beauty, you know, it's fleeting, you're going to lose it, and everyone has to contend with aging. So here, my ideal kind of Greek statue is coming to life and holding up a mirror to show me the reality of my situation. I anticipated I would end up being stuck in a city at the end of my life. Vision back here of this cluttered urban nightmare. I'm currently in Dunedin, which as cities go is a pretty good one, but it's very likely that I will end up having to go back to Sydney or similar to make a career or continue and improve my career as an artist. But it's just a reality that those who pursue the arts have to face, unfortunately. But yeah, my utopian ideal is the background landscape here. I moved to New Zealand for the mountain landscapes, and this is an exaggerated kind of mountain landscape back there, and the forest, and here we have my kind of urban ideal, which is a futuristic city that blends with a wilderness landscape, so you've got the best of both worlds in the one place, as opposed to this kind of conglomeration of glass boxes and crowded humanity that we've created for ourselves in cities today. So I'd like to think that you know, this is a recurring element in my artwork, so I'm trying to inspire architects, town planners, whatever, in the future to, you know, think of this rather than that as an ideal urban environment. Hopefully they will work to making the world a better place for us, more like this and less like that. Yeah, I think that about covers that one. This fellow, of course, is the same one as up here. Big inspiration for a few years, as well as a source of frustration and a challenge to my thinking processes. But yeah, I hope that's been of interest to some people out there. Meantime, thanks for watching and